The ghost had defeated many of Sukhbatar's spirits. But many more gathered aboard a mighty fleet where they readied a final assault on Tsushima. The ghosts decided to take over one of these ships and use it to assail Sukhbatar's fleet. With the Mongol crew defeated, the ghosts set sail down the coast. The ghosts needed no crew, for they had the help of the Kami. A strong wind filled their sails, and with each passing moment, they grew closer to Sukhbatar. Days travel, the ghosts came across a lone ship with its sails up. They quietly boarded the enemy vessel. The ghosts found freshly killed bodies in cages. Their trapped spirits illuminated by hanging lanterns. The final enemy fell. A voice cried out from a nearby cage. The spirits vanished into the fog. But a second ship raced to intercept the ghosts as a fiery bombardment rained down upon them. boarded the enemy ship. Strange lanterns swung on the seemingly empty deck. But in the fog, the ghosts saw the figures of spirits. Spirits emerged to challenge the ghosts. The ghosts set out to find the rest of the spirit fleet and Sukhbatar himself.
Out here, there will be nowhere for you to run, ghosts. The sea is an unforgiving place. Come and see the full might of my army. Once you're under my control, Io will take Tsushima with ease.
The ghosts made landfall at a known pirate cove. From all across the seas, pirates had gathered, eager to serve Sukhbatar, for he had promised them riches beyond belief, and all of Tsushima as a safe haven. An old dock led the ghosts deep into a graveyard of ships run aground. And on them, Mongol, Ronin, and bandit spirits forced by Sukhbatar to fight alongside one another. And Sukhbatar's army weakened.